Please be seated. Good morning, class of 2023. Congratulations to the class of 2023. My name is Lisa Rosen-Metsch, and I have the great honor to be the dean of Columbia University School of General Studies, or GS as we all know it. Welcome to this glorious day here on Morningside Heights for the GS Class Day ceremony, celebrating the accomplishments of the extraordinary GS Class of 2023. Woo! One more time! We are honored to have President Lee C. Bollinger and Executive Vice President and Dean of the Faculty of Arts and Sciences, Amy Hungerford, with us this morning. I also want to extend a warm welcome to Yosef Surrett, Dean of Columbia College and Vice President of Undergraduate Education, Dennis Mitchell, Executive Vice President for University Life and Senior Vice Provost for Faculty Advancement, and Julie Kornfeld, Vice Provost for Academic Programs. Welcome also to all the faculty members who have joined us this morning and are here with you in spirit. They have been your incredible teachers, mentors, and champions. I want to take a moment to recognize one faculty member in particular who is retiring this year. Please stand up, Professor Jean Howard. Professor Jean Howard from the Department of English and Comparative Literature. We want to recognize her for being such a treasured teacher, mentor, and friend to the students and staff at the Columbia School of General Studies. I would also like to extend a warm welcome to the deans and faculty from our partner institutions, including Dean and Professor Amy Kalmanovsky, Dean of Liss College at the Jewish Theological Seminary. Richard Walker, Dean of the College of Liberal Arts and Social Sciences at the City University of Hong Kong. Gail McElroy, Dean of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences at Trinity College, Dublin. And Emmanuel Catan, Director of the Allianz Program. They have joined us to celebrate the graduation of students in our joint and dual bachelor degree programs. These students, and you know who you are, have earned two bachelor's degrees in 4 years, one from JTS, Sciences Po, Tel Aviv University, Trinity, or the City University of Hong Kong, and one from Columbia University. I also extend a very special welcome to this year's Class Day speaker, Dean Keren Yarhi-Milo, GS Class of 2003, and the Dean of Columbia University's School of International and Public Affairs, SIPA. Special welcome to Columbia University Trustee Shirley Wang, members of the GS Board of Visitors, including our Chair, Allison Fillmore, members of the Executive Board of the GS Alumni Association, and all the GS alumni who have joined us today. I would like to also recognize our amazing dean sitting here on stage and the entire GS team who work very hard on your behalf every day. Please give a thank you to those advising deans and all the people who supported you. Finally, and looking to each of the sides, a very special welcome to all the family and friends who are here today in person, joining us virtually or in spirit. I know how important you are to each and every student who is celebrating here, who we are celebrating here today, and I know this is an incredibly meaningful moment for you. Class of 2023, take a moment to thank the people who have supported you, again, who may be here in spirit, joining us virtually, or right here. Please stand up and take a moment to thank them. Okay, please be seated. As the ninth dean of Columbia GS and the very proud first alumna to be dean of this exceptional school, I am so, yes, that is very, very proud. I am so proud that our school stands as a beacon for the future of higher education in our society. The creation of Columbia GS in 1947 represents a milestone in the evolution of undergraduate education at Ivy League universities. What makes Columbia GS unique is that we actively recruit students who have taken an untraditional path in life and academics, and we integrate our brilliant students fully into our distinguished, rigorous undergraduate program. We are also the incubator for innovative dual and joint BA programs that offer students a unique opportunity to engage with cutting-edge international education. As a proud graduate of our flagship joint program with Liss College at the Jewish Theological Seminary, I can attest to the effectiveness of this model. This year, we have 29 graduates from the joint program with Liss College. We have 145 graduates from our program with Sciences Po in France. Yeah. 25 from City University of Hong Kong. 46 from Trinity College Dublin. And 3 from our newest program with Tel Aviv University. At Columbia GS, you will also find nearly 400 veterans of the US military, 108 of whom will be graduating today. Additionally, another 64 graduates are international military veterans. We are proud of our commitment to veterans and their families and grateful for their service. Whether Columbia GS students are first-generation college students, 195 of whom are graduating here, first in their families to go to college, today, performing artists, parents, fashion models, filmmakers, or community college graduates, musicians, entrepreneurs, new Americans, or international students, they receive the same superb education as all other Columbia undergraduates, and they, you in front of me, excel. Members of the class of 2023, all 765 of you, you are such a special class. As many of you began your studies or had your first year of studies interrupted with the pandemic, while those were very challenging and painful times, you had determination, resolve, and commitment to your undergraduate studies here at Columbia. This is not surprising, as you, our amazing GS graduates, have always charted your own course. You have not followed the traditional path to undergraduate education. You are innovators, you are pathbreakers, you are courageous, and you have brought an entrepreneurial spirit to Columbia University. You truly make the undergraduate classroom like no other, with your intellectual curiosities, diversity, life experiences, hard work, and love for the study of the mind, and your love for our treasured Columbia University, and particularly our treasured GS community. I have gotten to know so many of you as I look out today, and I am beyond excited for you, for what you have achieved, and for what you will do next, and to count you, each one of you, as lifelong members of the Columbia intellectual and alumni communities. Congratulations again. I now have the honor to introduce Columbia University President Lee C. Bollinger. Lee C. Bollinger became Columbia University's 19th president in 2002. It was not right after the pandemic, it was right after 9/11, and he has certainly faced and brought us through beautifully so many challenges over his 21-year time here as president at Columbia. He is the longest-serving Ivy League president. Under his leadership, Columbia has redefined what it means to be a great research university in the 21st century. Distinguished by comprehensive academic excellence, an innovative and sustainable approach to global engagement, and the institution's most ambitious campus expansion in over a century. President Bollinger is Columbia's first Cephalo professor of the university, a member of the Columbia Law School faculty, and one of the nation's foremost First Amendment scholars. Some of you I know have had the honor to be a student in President Bollinger's undergraduate course that he teaches every fall, Freedom of Speech and Press. Earlier this year, just at the beginning of 2023, President Bollinger published A Legacy of Discrimination, The Essential Constitutionality of Affirmative Action, which continues his long-term focus and engagement on the issue of affirmative action. As president of the University of Michigan, President Bollinger led the school's landmark civil rights litigation in Grutta versus Bollinger, a Supreme Court decision that for the first time upheld the constitutional right of colleges and universities to engage in affirmative action to advance diversity in higher education. I am deeply grateful to President Bollinger for his unwavering support to the students and the mission of the Columbia School of General Studies, and for me as the ninth dean of this great school. We were thrilled to honor him this year on Veterans Day at our Columbia Military Ball for his bold leadership in bringing NROTC back to Columbia's campus and for ensuring that Columbia University is the destination Ivy League and highly selective institution for veterans. We are more than double the whole Ivy League combined in student veterans. But moreover, President Bollinger, in my many conversations, starting from when he interviewed me for this job, has always recognized that a school like Columbia GS brings both to our university community and the world at large something pretty spectacular. He even coined the term the genius of GS. It is my privilege and deep honor to introduce to you the 19th president of Columbia University, Lee C. Bollinger.
Thank you very much, Lisa. The School of General Studies is incredibly fortunate to have Lisa Rosen-Metsch as the dean. She is someone who, in her being, understands what makes this community of students and alumni so remarkable. I would also like to recognize this morning's Class Day speaker, Keren Yarhi-Milo, the Dean of the School of International Public Affairs, and herself yet another proud GS alumna. And I want to say that I have a special bond with GS because I was 1 year old when GS was formed. To the members of the class of 2023 who are with us this morning, I offer my deepest congratulations to your family and friends. Know that everyone on this podium is celebrating alongside you and these graduates and soon-to-be graduates. I will speak to everyone in a longer address on the big commencement on Wednesday. So I want to keep my remarks here very brief. I have a very simple, straightforward message for you. You have been part of something that is unique in the world, really unique. The brilliant idea that talent and the desire for education become manifest at different stages of life, that life experiences may enhance those qualities and provide even more fertile intellectual ground for education to take root and flourish. The idea that the contributions of people like yourselves can make a conventional academic community even better, those ideas are profound. They are the defining elements of the School of General Studies. And yet, it is this brilliant idea that is brilliant because it's unique. It has not been integrated into the conventional structure of American higher education, except at Columbia and the School of General Studies. And it even took us several decades to realize it. It has been my privilege and honor to see the students of General Studies, you, become one and the same with our undergraduate community of scholars. Now, you understandably may not be so interested in how all of this came about. Like all of us, your lives have been determined by the actions of countless people prior to your arrival on the scene. We always tend to take the world as we encounter it somewhat for granted. But in this case, in your case, there is a special need, I would even say a responsibility, to take heed of what the world was like before and what it is like now. You are the living example. Your success is the living example of how the world as structured is not always properly aligned, not to its own goals, to educate each new generation, nor to the way the world should be, treating all minds at all stages of life as equally capable and receiving and benefiting from an education. I say this not so that you will make it a mission of your life to spread Columbia's School of General Studies to every institution of higher learning, a worthy goal, to be sure, but rather because you should be even more alert and sensitive to, generally, how structures in life defeat our larger ideals. I hope you can take your own experience, in other words, and see misalignments and underappreciated potential anywhere. I look forward to seeing you at our general commencement on Wednesday. Congratulations to the class of 2023.
Thank you, President Bollinger. It has been an honor of a lifetime to work under your transformational leadership. And I think President Bollinger means what he says. It should not be taken for granted. Of the 17 schools at Columbia University, two of those schools are led by GS alum. And I'm not sure you can say that about any other school. So it's now, on that note, it is my deep pleasure to introduce to you our amazing class day speaker, Keren Yarhi-Milo, who graduated from Columbia GS 20 years ago in 2003. Keren Yarhi-Milo is the Dean of Columbia's School of International and Public Affairs, SIPA, and the Adlai E. Stevenson Professor of International Relations. In 2022, Dean Yarhi-Milo won the International Study Association's Emerging Scholar Award, which recognizes, quote, scholars who have made, through their body of publications, the most significant contribution to the field of security studies. Her most recent book, which represents many books, Who Fights for Reputation? The Psychology of Leaders in International Conflict, was recognized by the American Political Science Association as the best book in foreign policy. Dean Yarhi-Milo has also published extensively in academic journals, receiving honors from the American Political Science Association, the International Studies Association, and the Journal of Conflict Resolution. Dean Yarhi-Milo joined the Columbia faculty in 2019 after a decade at Princeton. Before becoming SIPA's dean, she served for 2 years as director of SIPA's Arnold A. Saltzman Institute of War and Peace Studies, launching the Emerging Voices in National Security and Intelligence program to attract and support students from underrepresented backgrounds interested in pursuing careers in those fields. This fall, Dean Yarhi-Milo will co-teach a course with Secretary Hillary Rodham Clinton called Inside the Situation Room. I know a course that I've heard many students want to be part of. This will be a course designed to teach students to analyze and understand the many factors of foreign policy decision making. Dean Yarhi-Milo has a bold vision for SIPA, which she calls SIPA 2.0, and has recently launched Columbia's new Institute for Global Politics. Beyond her numerous and prestigious academic achievements and recognition, she and her husband, Ariel Milo, also from the GS class of 2003, have been loyal and generous supporters of GS students in the years since their graduation, with Ariel serving as a member of the GS Board of Visitors, and Keren was the inaugural keynote speaker of GS's Dean's Women's Leader Roundtable for Women Veteran Students. Keren was an outstanding student at Columbia GS, majoring in political science, graduating summa cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa. We are beyond proud of what Keren has accomplished in 20 years since graduating GS. And we also welcome here today Ariel, who I mentioned, and her beautiful boys, Jonathan and Daniel. I am honored to introduce to you my dear friend and the Dean of SIPA and our GS alum, class of 2003, Keren Yarhi-Milo.
Good morning, President Bollinger, Dean Rosen-Metsch, EVP of Arts and Science, Amy Hungerford, faculty, staff, family, and friends, thank you for inviting me to share this joyful day. I would like to also acknowledge my husband, Ariel Milo, as Lisa said, a proud GS alum, and our wonderful boys, Jonathan and Daniel, who are with us today. This ceremony is their first introduction to the GS family. Yeah. And to you, the class of 2023, congratulations. Now, I have some idea what's going through your heads right now, because 20 years ago, almost to the day, I sat where you're sitting. As I look out at your faces, a mix of emotions comes flooding back. I know many of you are as thrilled as I was to have made it to the finish line. A few of you are holding the hands of a fellow GS graduate like I was. Let me tell you, you might even marry them. For some of you, this day is bittersweet. Well, it certainly was for me. Even amidst all the excitement, I was devastated because my parents were not at my graduation. They'd put everything they had into my education and could not afford the trip to New York City. Some of you are confident about the future. Others are as anxious as I was. On paper, at least, it looked like I had it all figured out. I was heading to the University of Pennsylvania to pursue a PhD. But in reality, between you and I was lost. As the ceremony went on, I agonized, am I making the right decision? Is this the wrong decision? What am I doing? Maybe these questions are a little too familiar to some of you. Graduates, whatever emotions you are experiencing, I hope one is chief among them. An overwhelming sense of pride because you've earned a degree from the Columbia University School of General Studies. Now, as I look back, there are so many things I wish I could tell my 24-year-old self. But since I cannot go back in time, well, one of the many ways Back to the Future misled my generation, today I'd like to share that advice with you. Now, this really is a full circle moment, because 20 years ago, in his first year as president, President Bollinger shook my hand and gave me my GS diploma. Two decades later, it's his last year as president and my first year as dean. Last fall, Lee delivered a superb convocation speech with 7 recommendations to the incoming class. So today, as a tribute to our president, to my mentor and friend, and his enduring legacy, I humbly offer 7 things I wish I had known on my graduation day. Now, if you think 7 things are too many, I originally considered basing this on another presidential speech, President Wilson's 14 points of world peace. So consider yourself lucky. All right. First, behind every triumph is a world of private struggle. From Lisa's generous introduction, and by the way, you have the most brilliant, amazing, loving, and caring dean in this university. But from her generous introduction, it might sound like these last 20 years have been one success after another. Well, that's far from the story. When she talks about dozens of articles that were published, I remember 40 more rejection letters. When she talks about the words I've received from my books, I remember the profound self-doubt that accompanies each one of them. When she talks about graduating with honors, I remember being heartbroken that my mentor advised me to get my PhD at UPenn instead of Columbia, to become a more well-rounded scholar. In hindsight, he was right. He was always right. But at the time, not continuing here felt like a huge failure. You see, that's the thing about CVs. The bullet points tell you someone's accomplishments. But if you really want to know what they're made of, ask them about the spaces in between. Be proud not just of this day, but of the struggle that brought you to this moment. The long hours at Butler Library, the frustration of trying to grasp a difficult concept, and of course, the difficulty of balancing it all with your life outside university's hall. Today's is the result of a lot of hard work, and the grind doesn't end here. There will never be a perfect moment when you can say, I made it. And even if there is, it may be followed by a deep sense of anxiety that you'll never live up to that, to what that moment connotes. But if you approach the road ahead with the same determination and passion that brought you here, the struggle itself will be its own reward and the part of your story you're proudest to tell. Second, big dream. Sorry. Dream big. And big dreams will follow. And if you're already dreaming big, dream bigger. Every graduation is a culmination of a long journey. In my case, well, it started in middle school. Growing up, I was fascinated by Madeleine Albright. She captivated me first as the U.S. ambassador to the UN, then as the first woman to serve as the U.S. Secretary of State. She made her way fearlessly into rooms of foreign leaders, most of them men, and spoke her mind. And they listened, and so did I. So I did what we used to do before Google was invented. I picked up a book. And I learned that she attributed her skills to a university called Columbia. And I asked my parents if I could go there for my bat mitzvah trip. Now, I grew up in Israel with parents who did not attend college because they had to work multiple jobs to make ends meet from a very young age. So when I asked to visit, they were reluctant. It was a big ask financially. But they were also a bit confused. You see, they couldn't figure out what I felt so strongly about visiting Colombia, a Latin American country. So I told them, no, it's New York City. So my mother brought me here in middle school, and I was walking through the gates. I knew this was where I belonged. I picked up the course bulletin and highlighted all the classes I would take. Getting to GS a decade later was one of the best moments of my life. But even having achieved that dream, I could have never imagined I would return to Columbia as a professor, that I would be standing here as a dean of SIPA, that I would teach a class with another US Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton. The moral of the story is this: be bold, be ambitious, not because all your dreams will come true, but because having a dream inspires you to work hard like nothing else can. That leads me to another hard-learned lesson. Having a plan is great, but the real test is how well you adapt when life intervenes. Class of 2023, you know this all too well. Since you came to campus, you've seen a pandemic, a long overdue reckoning with racism, and a financial crisis. Faced with isolation, you built community. Faced with loss, you developed resilience. Faced with change, you evolved. Adaptation is always hard. It forces you to confront and dismantle the illusion that you are in control. I had to learn that lesson when I was on the job market for the first time. For any doctoral student, the call to come interview for a tenure-track position is one of the big moments of an early career in academia. Well, I got that call when I was in the delivery room in Lenox Hill Hospital, getting an epidural, about to give birth to my son. When I saw the 609 area code, I knew it was Princeton, so I answered the phone. On the other side of the line was a famous professor who innocently asked, "Is this a good time?" I looked around me at the horrified faces of the doctor, the nurses, and my husband, and said, "Sure, I have about 10 minutes. The professor invited me to campus for an interview. 2 weeks later, I showed up, wearing clothes that hardly fit, exhausted from working on my slides while caring for a newborn. This messy scene did not match the image I've held about about the start of my career, or motherhood, for that matter. After all, I had a brilliant plan to interview for jobs before giving birth. But my son came 5 weeks early, so I had two choices. I could cling to my quickly unraveling plan, or I could adapt. That decision you'll have to make not once, but over and over again. As I'm learning as dean, ironically, as you advance in your life and career, adapting may prove increasingly difficult, but it also become even more necessary. Of course, adapting to life's curveballs is a lot easier when you are not alone. Which brings me to something else I hadn't yet realized as I sat on the south lawn in my regalia. As a wise woman once said, it takes a village. I started building my village when I took my first political science class with the great Professor Robert Jervis. Yeah. That class began one of the most important professional relationships of my life. Bob's writing inspired me to become a political scientist, and Bob became my mentor, offering indispensable advice until the moment he passed away. Bob was just one of many points in a circle of collegiality, love, and friendship that surrounded and supported me throughout my career. So here I was at Princeton, I got a job, a year into my career as an assistant professor, racing against the tenure clock, when my 16-month-old son's pediatrician informed us that something was wrong. He had a motor planning disorder, and without intensive therapy, he might never speak. We were terrified. The news put everything in perspective. And I knew exactly where I needed to be. So I quit. Or at least I tried to. Thankfully, Princeton did not let me. They put me on medical leave so I could spend 40 or 50 hours a week in therapy with my boy. For me, deciding to quit was easy. It was the return that proved much, much harder. I had less than 3 years left to earn tenure. I was very behind. My senior colleagues at Princeton told me I needed to achieve what seemed like an impossible feat, publish multiple articles and a new book, all from scratch. It was up or out. I did not think I had it in me. I was mentally and physically spent. I was really ready to give up. This was when I really needed my village. You're going to do it, Keren, and we're going to help. Those were Bob's words. I took a sabbatical from Princeton and came back, where else? Columbia. To write my book. I was surrounded by extraordinary brain power, but more importantly, by the love and confidence of my friends and colleagues, some of whom are here today. I'm proud of that book. I'm really proud that I got tenure, but I'm even prouder of my son, Jonathan, who was the hardest working toddler I've ever known. And today, yes, baby. Today not only speaks, but speaks three languages. No matter what challenges you face, the journey will be more meaningful if you face them with the village you've been assembling. And when you are in a position to pay it forward, become a mentor. Be their village and watch them thrive. Because graduates, with the privilege of a world-class education comes a profound responsibility to serve your community. And here is the fifth lesson I wish to impart. Great universities like this one exist not only to cultivate scholars, but to nurture the next generations of leaders, to instill an ethos of service and a commitment to giving back. As a dean of SIPA, I feel extraordinarily fortunate to have a chance to serve the community that sparked my imagination, launched my career, and helped me make my comeback to academia. What Columbia has given me, I hope and strive to give our students. This is why I took this job and why I will never want to leave Columbia ever again. Today, I charge you with a similar mission. As you go out into the world, take every opportunity to give back. Not just to Columbia, but to your field of study, to the place where you live, to young people who dream of following in your footsteps. Because at the end of the day, what's true at GS is true in life. Fulfillment comes not from what you achieve, but from how deeply you invest in the people around you. The sixth thing I wish I'd known 20 years ago is that moments of uncertainty and flux, in those moments, leadership matters. You see, I study psychology of decision-making of leaders, and when it comes to understanding the impact of leaders on the world, there have long been two schools of thought. The conventional wisdom was that individual leaders don't matter. You could replace one leader with another, but eventually they will all be forced to respond to the constraints posed by the structure of the international system. Others come to contend that it's all about the leaders. If you want to understand the world, you should focus on their personalities, their histories, their belief systems. In reality, neither theory is sufficient, and instead, it's the combination of leaders and context that shapes events most profoundly. And in certain moments, moments of flux and uncertainty, that's when leaders matter a great deal. Now, this is a moment of flux and uncertainty. You are graduating into a world shaped by geopolitical realignment, rising poverty, democratic backsliding, and a climate crisis. But this moment of uncertainty is a moment of opportunity. It's a chance for entrepreneurial leadership, fresh ideas, and serious advocacy to make a difference. It's a chance for you to make a difference by practicing what you've learned here at GS. You've learned that thinking deeply is not just about what you know, but about examining your assumptions and biases. And if we've done our jobs right, you've learned to engage with others, including people with whom you don't agree. By thinking deeply, I hope you've also learned that emotions are not a hindrance to rationality. They connect us to each other and to ourselves. They help leaders build consensus and can fuel the most profound and meaningful forms of change. And speaking of passion, the last thing I wish I'd understood on my graduation day is that graduating from GS does not mean leaving GS, because GS never leaves you. Class of 2023, you came to Columbia as dancers, athletes, and musicians, veterans, parents, and small business owners, novelists, chefs, and plumbers. Many of you overcame extraordinary things: incarceration, abuse, illness, war. Others had ascended to the highest heights of a profession, but always felt that something was missing. Some of you were pursuing a second degree, others a second chance. Today, 550 unique journeys converge on the South Lawn. And before you move on to your next adventure, stop for a moment. Look around you and take it all in. This is the most socioeconomically diverse undergraduate college in the Ivy League. You are native New Yorkers, international students, and the children of immigrants and refugees. The youngest graduate today is 20, and the oldest is 61. Talk about living your big dream. While we're on the subject of dreams, I want to recognize the people who helped you achieve this one. All of the parents, family members, and friends with us today in person and in spirit, thank you. Sitting before me are future diplomats and Supreme Court justices, scholars whose research will change the world and save lives, storytellers who will spark empathy and joy. This is a school of entrepreneurs, brilliant thinkers, big dreamers, and curious minds. It is a school with a soul. And graduate, that soul is you. So go out, write your next chapters, do good, and make Columbia proud. We will be cheering on, we'll be cheering you on every step of the way, and we will be here for you when you seek a source of solace, a haven for renewal, and a home away from home. Owls, it's time to spread your wings, and 20 years from now, I look forward to hearing your advice for the class of 2043. Thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you, Dean Yarhi-Milo. As you can imagine, there's so much pride and excitement at SIPA. And I went to their gala and everyone said, I am SIPA. So Keren, you are SIPA, but you are also always GS. Now I would like to invite to the podium the president of the Military Veterans of Columbia University, the MilVets, a member of the graduating class of 2023, Grayson Noyes.
Good morning. to the Columbia University School of General Studies, class of 2023. We have persisted and triumphed. Congratulations, everyone. As Dean Rosen-Metsch said, students from 64 countries compose our graduating class. We are globally minded citizens, military veterans, former community college students, athletes, dancers, bankers, writers, and more. One in four graduates were the first in their family to earn a college degree. GS is a groundbreaking place, to say the least, the most diverse college in the Ivy League. But this did not happen overnight. It required the innovative leadership of many, with President Lee C. Bollinger at the forefront. President Bollinger has led the Columbia community for 21 years and established a network of 9 Columbia global centers on 4 continents. President Bollinger's dedication to GS's international dual degree programs was integral in providing all Columbia undergraduates a global perspective and unparalleled educational opportunities. And President Bollinger took steps to further his conviction that our nation is best served when institutions like Columbia educate and include in our classrooms veterans and future military leaders. He is a preeminent scholar of democratic ideals, free speech and expression, and a staunch advocate for diversity and justice in our nation's universities. It is for these reasons, among many others, that on behalf of the class of 2023, Dean Rosen-Metsch and I would like to present President Lee C. Bollinger with a GS Owl, an important symbol of our school, in recognition of his 21 years of leadership and commitment to the School of General Studies. Please, a round of applause.
Grayson, please don't stay up here. Okay. So I am now going to present the Alumni Key Award. Each year, the Alumni Key is awarded to a senior who has achieved distinction both academically and through service to the undergraduate community. I want to thank and invite GS Board of Visitors Chair Allison Fillmore, class of 1997, to help me present this award. And Allison has been an incredible leader of our board. Thank you, Allison.
Thank you.
I am thrilled to say that the 2023 Alumni Key Award goes to Grayson Noyes. Okay, originally from the San Francisco Bay Area, Grayson spent time studying at the Community College of Marin and served in the United States Marine Corps as a military police officer before coming to Columbia. During his time at GS, Grayson dedicated himself to serving the student veteran community, serving as president of the MilVets for 2 years and volunteering as a service to school mentor, helping veterans with their college applications and organizing fundraisers among our student veterans and other veterans to support displaced persons from Afghanistan and Ukraine. Grayson has worked in the legal department of the New York City Department of Veterans Services and was a recipient of the GS Spirit Award in 2022. Grayson graduates with a major in political science, is a member of Phi Beta Kappa and the Columbia Honor Society, and plans to attend Columbia Law School in the fall. Thank you, Grayson, for your dedication to our GS community, and congratulations on being awarded the 2023 Alumni Key Award. Congratulations. Okay. I am now pleased to present the 7th Annual Campbell Award. The Campbell Award is given to a student from each school at Columbia University who shows exceptional leadership and Columbia spirit as exemplified by the late Bill Campbell, Columbia College Class of 1962, Teachers College Class of 1964, Chair Emeritus of the Board of Trustees, and co-founder of the Columbia Alumni Association. This year's Campbell Award is presented to James Harvey Elliott II. Come on up, James. James has an amazing GS story as a proud father, returning citizen, 2022 Truman Scholar, an exceptional Columbia student and member of our community. Before coming to GS, James spent time studying at Delaware Technical Community College, where he went on to be international president of the prestigious honor society Phi Theta Kappa. During his time as a student leader, James served as a mentor for the Justice Ambassador's Youth Council at the Columbia Center for Justice, and has been passionate about advocating for prison reform. He has spoken at prisons and community colleges throughout the U.S. and works to bring awareness to the effects of mass incarceration, particularly by forging new pathways for people who are incarcerated to pursue higher education. This year, James served as the GS student representative to the GS Columbia College Committee on Instruction and previously served on the Educational Policy and Planning Committee. James, who majored in African American and African Diaspora Studies with a concentration in political science, plans to take the LSAT and apply to law school after graduation, and also to spend time with his beautiful daughter who's in the house as she begins kindergarten. Congratulations, James Harvey Elliott II, and thank you for your many contributions. I now have the honor of presenting the Columbia GS Class of 2023 Salutatorian, Alexander Alvalade Ximenes. If you can stand up. Alexander is from Manhattanville and also grew up in Western Europe and the Middle East. A son of two multilingual immigrants, he has spent much of his life advocating for secular democracy, women's rights, and human rights. Alexander was appointed a philosophy writing tutor and received departmental honors in both philosophy and political science at Hunter College. At Columbia, Alexander excelled, was named to the Dean's List, and inducted into the GS Honor Society, the Pi Sigma Alpha Society, and Phi Beta Kappa. He graduates summa cum laude with majors in both political science and Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. He is a published scholar, and outside of his research, Alexander has maintained a commitment to public service, teaching English as a second language, a culinary health class, and 3 GED classes to new immigrants and people who are formerly incarcerated in New York City. After graduation, Alexander will work for a real estate law firm in New York City and plans to attend law school and to become a law professor and trial attorney. Congratulations, Alexander. I now have the pleasure of bringing to the stage your amazing Dean of Students, Professor Marlyn Delva.
Good morning, everyone. It is now my distinct honor and privilege to introduce the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts. Dean Rosen-Metsch, it is my honor to present to you the candidates for this degree. Zainab Jama, major psychology. Daniela Juarez, major psychology. Grayson Patrick Noyes, major political science. James Harvey Elliott II, major African American studies. Jennifer Todaro, major archaeology. Alexander Friedman, major economics. Allison Darn, major American studies. Isabella Noonan, major history. Benjamin Wasserberg, major sociology. Michelle Bros, major biological sciences. Victor Charlette, major financial economics. Raj Kosal, major history. Sarah Caro, major history. Noel Turlington, major information sciences. Miguel Cebada, major English. Ian Frankel, major political science. Marie Deer, major sociology. Alexandra Gracheva, major political science. Beata Ximenes, major economics. Emma Nakayoshi, major English. William O'Connor Grugan, major Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. Samuel George, political science. Kayla Morales, anthropology. Ashley Tan, political science. Yareen Reindorp, neuroscience and behavior. Jonathan Bugmartin, psychology. Isaac Scott, visual arts. Deshaun Tabor, anthropology. Kim Lee Tor, computer science. Noor Elgawali, sustainable development. Dongjae Min, economics. Crystal Jackson, political science. Connor Karp, English. Melody Agoran, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African Studies. Chu Chi Jen, Computer Science. Andrew Hollins, Economics. Shirler Gardner, History. Michelle Passos King, Psychology. Alana Kelly, Sociology. Maya Saar, Art History. Noelie Alves Santos Flor, Political Science. Ray Christopher Apache, Computer Science. Inez Abi Morad, Economics. Hela Amin, Economics Philosophy. Lenny Arahan, Mathematics Statistics. Pilar Arriaga, Sustainable Development. Taryn Arshakian, Financial Economics. Kevin Ayaz, Mathematics Statistics. Matias Alvarez, Political Science. Aditi Kapoor, English. Maria Tomboro, Film and Media Studies. Aylin Demorap, History Information Sciences. Michael Bollinger, Computer Science. Jake Babcock, Psychology. Elizabeth Bordy, Sociology. Aaron Buckley, Political Science. Audrey Brown, English. Maya Blair, History. Eden Astorino, Psychology. Victoria Ann Ardilian, Financial Economics. Marissa Aronson. Helen Aboa, Financial Economics. George Duncan Adamson, Financial Economics. Keo Asir Rodriguez, Psychology. Timothy Bowen, Sustainable Development. Sydney Brown, African American Studies. Katarina Bustos, Creative Writing. Yasha Brudno, Financial Economics. Sylvester Benson, Neuroscience and Behavior. Yarden Bengoa, Neuroscience and Behavior. Kadar Arshad, Political Science. Thomas O'Clair, Political Science. Tom Utrecht, Political Science. Juliet Aze, Evolutionary Biology of the Human Species. Nika Afshar, Philosophy. Judah Altman, Philosophy. Maya Beer, Neuroscience and Behavior. Gordon Hansen, Financial Economics. Lila Beldner, Human Rights. Jacob Baumstein, Information Sciences. Joshua Brelleren, Computer Science and Mathematics. Joshua Bechtel, History Theory of Architecture. Juliana Bongiorno, Classical Studies. Josh Brown, Economics. Stacy Brown, Neuroscience and Behavior. Nicole Bonakarski, Evolutionary Biology of the Human Species. Luam Orega, Political Science. Joseph Alalu, History. Aria Bright, Financial Economics. Jackie Bennett, Financial Economics. Sang Sheng Ba, Computer Science and Mathematics. Shelby Burns, Human Rights. Junit May Bedane, Ethnicity and Race Studies. Joshua Bailey, Financial Economics. Taylor Bronson, Political Science. Rachel Benedict, History. Karsten Barnes, Economic Statistics. Michelle Brucker, Political Science. Pauline Bromberg, Financial Economics. Emma Blythe, political science. Steele Carrier, economics. Rodolphe Casabianca, political science. Edward Conklin, Russian literature and culture. Peter Chen, economics, political science. Amy Choi, neuroscience and behavior. Rose Bootball, political science. Clara Bonin, human rights. Isis Blaches, sociology. Anna Bartu, political science. Khadija Balnade, sociology. Mina Borkin, American studies. Isabel Bon, human rights. Elise Combe, political science. Sean Conlon, political science. Haley Cherry, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. Catherine Callahan, English. David Chen, political science. Liam Cohen, philosophy. Kyle Bergen, financial economics. Sophia Bianchi, computer science. Salvatore Cocuza, financial economics. Tyler Burks, biological sciences. Martian Basaga, history. Brittany Bailey, anthropology. Yingsun Chen, biological sciences. Ryan Chapman Schnupp, political science. Suyan Choi, psychology. Jeanette Quisana, sustainable development. Thomas Chen, philosophy. Remy Shui, political science. Chris Camp, psychology. John Connolly, English. Andrew Caspi, history. Andriana Clark, environmental biology. Erica Carrion, psychology. Emma Rose Carpenter, political science. Caroline Chouinard, sustainable development. Chi Chen, psychology. Ching Tung Chang, psychology. Chloe Chow, political science. Marcus DeSanto, creative writing. Gabriella Marie Chaffee, political science. Manon Kunfravu, sustainable development. Rosalie Casillas, economics and political science. Claire Chandon, psychology. Kaylee Coleman, sociology. Lauren Carroll, art history. Angelo Diglirolamo, computer science, neuroscience, and behavior. Wendy Du, financial economics. Connor Diaz, applied mathematics, earth sciences. Allegra Della Ragnon, English. Olivia Diaz Banyon, economics. Clara De Bono, human rights. Fabian Cacarchi, Hispanic Studies. Shulamit Kravanche, Urban Studies. Don Amiran Cohen, Economics, Political Science. Louis Chang, Data Science. Alice Chu, Sociology. Ian Kang Chu, Urban Studies. Aditi Chatterjee, Political Science. Chloe Constantino, History. Stephen Charles, Music. Savatna Dorshevek, Physics. Vina Dinavahi, Psychology. Caitlin Dalbon, Psychology. Ralph Diab, Political Science, Statistics. Beatrice Circilli, Political Science. Matthew Capuano Rizzo, Sustainable Development. Surip Chung, Political Science. Sang-Yung Choi, Film and Media Studies. Bowen Chen, Physics. Anna Cardenas Landgrave, Sustainable Development. Annabella DiFrancesco, Psychology. Dana DiMartino, Economics. Paola Duran, History. Tomas Diaz Piva Imparato, Anthropology. Matthew Donovan, Sociology. Savannah Eklund, Medical Humanities. Hannah Ibrum, Psychology. Christy Chen, Financial Economics. Christopher Cox, Computer Science. Keith Cruz, Computer Science. Crystal Cook, History. Zoe Dupuis, Sustainable Development. Aurelian Ethoven, Political Science. Jason Ho, Financial Economics. Guillermo de Rigo Peter, Political Science. Jessica DiRocco. Barang Garakani, Film and Media Studies. Taylor Fogarty, Psychology. Marie Fibriette, Sustainable Development. Andreas Freund, Information Sciences. Cole Fisher, Psychology. Rina Fusa, Economics. Khalil Ello, Economics. Austin Edgar, Computer Science. Rooney Exuma, Comparative Literature and Society. Owen Brennan Duty, Political Science. Pudis Dawiyang, Computer Science. Daphne Demirdelin, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African Studies. Tanvi Gupta, Economics. Sophia Giordano, Political Science. Hannah Gallagher, History. Leah Fishman, Philosophy. Olivia Flattery Lavi, English. Laura Fairlamb, Human Rights. Harry Foster, Creative Writing, English. Elena Flack, Philosophy, Political Science. Anna Franco Solano, Psychology. John Patrick Ferriera, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African Studies. Matthew Friedman, History. Zachary Fisher, History. Orla Frenoy, Political Science. Hernan Gallego, Computer Science. Aaron Farage, Sociology. Matthew Griffith, Applied Mathematics. Julie Hanot, Financial Economics. Victor Gout, Human Rights. Shlomo Fingiger, Psychology. Molly Gleason, Visual Arts. Hania Giagusu, Computer Science. Paul Guidos, Political Science. Pierre Grados, Sustainable Development. Trey Greeno, History. Craig Gilliam, Economics. Nadav Garibi, Financial Economics. Oh, Niccolo Gismondi, Political Science. Isabella Graham Martinez, Mathematics Statistics. Roberto Garcia, History. Kyle Gordon, Political Science. Eliana Garcia, Biological Sciences. Marine Gapahan, Political Science.
Chiara
Guigyu, Computer Science. Quentin Gumi, Financial Economics. Casey Hill Garba, Women and Gender Studies. Charles Greenstein, Computer Science, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African Studies. Melanie Grinholk, Financial Economics. Tom Gaffney, Economics Mathematics. August Gold, History. Sarah Gruber, Political Science. Rory Glantz, Economics. Samuel Grossman, Political Science. Casey Gibbs, Human Rights. Anna Hirsch, Political Science. John Hopper, Philosophy. Youngmin Han, Psychology. Madeline Hearn, English. Quinn Houlihan, Political Science. Danielle Heinlein, Political Science. Christina Howard, Slavic Studies. Chungyun Her, Chemistry. Javier Hadoy, Financial Economics. Oliver Harris, Psychology. Rosa Gagan, French and Francophone Studies. Najwa Haska, Political Science. Ellie Houlihan, Comparative Literature and Society. Vida Hahn, Sustainable Development. Solomon Hoffman, Financial Economics. Joseph Jackson, Political Science. Meng Huang Ho, Computer Science. Jonathan Hatala, Environmental Science. Alexander Hiller, English. Keegan Hakim, Film and Media Studies. Amri Harlap, political science. Lauren Hendricks, biological sciences. Noga Hurwitz, information sciences. Julian Hunt, computer science. Rahil Bhatia, economics. Tara Jovic, film and media studies. Simon Jin, human rights sociology. Leslie Johnson, psychology. Henry Koth, political science. Clara Harrington. Clara Harrington, human rights. Sophia Harrington, human rights. Tiffany Peach, political science. Virginia House, American Studies. Liron Hayon, computer science. Alexandra Hoagland, computer science. Ryan Kalugan, sustainable development. Kevin Kuo, computer science. Kay Kim, economics. Daniel Kang, financial economics. Jackson Kanishnik, economics. Dee Dee Kim, art history. Soyoung Jung, East Asian studies. Marin Irfat, anthropology. Sabina Grace Imanova, political science. Victoria Kalfas, human rights. Gisette Harris, English. Crystal Herrera Peria, ethnicity and race studies. Andrew Ken, computer science. Marika Carolyn Keller, psychology. Min Jin Kim, sociology. Kaya Kim, women and gender studies. Alan Han, financial economics. Joshua Kubuskinski, sociology. Derek Lorenzo, computer science. Beatrice Klein, political science. Olivia Jenkins, history. Aaron Ashiktas, economics and political science. Abigail Ilfeld, political science. James Aikida, psychology. Mary Claire Joseph, sustainable development. Don Lee, computer science. Maya Lemesh, sustainable development. Solène Lesquartain, political science. Laura Lambert, financial economics. Zoe Lerouge MR, sustainable development. Emery Lecron, sociology. James Kettle, information sciences. Quintus Kilborn, computer science. Newman Core, economics. Joshua Kohlberg, psychology. Trevor Kozis, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. David Kim Brady, applied mathematics. Bill Liu, financial economics. Maximilian Lim, financial economics. Holden Lee, mathematics statistics. Cash Luing, financial economics. Nicholas Lopez de Salinas, Sustainable Development. Michael Nguyen, Financial Economics. Anna Lugard, History. Sangmin Lee, Statistics. Zihao Lee, Human Rights, Political Science. Jean LaCap, Philosophy. Selena Huo, Philosophy. Audrey Coast, History. Jonah Lubau, Psychology Statistics. Hugh Mansfield, History. Gary Maita Lizarraga, Political Science. Marilee Jacobson Moe, Psychology. Tim Mahakatazinov, Psychology. Omid Moradi, Political Science. Gabrielle Drill, Film and Media Studies. Andrew Latvis, History. Ido Liren, Financial Economics. Augustine Lacroix, Economics. Mac Lindsay, Chemistry. Katrina Lockley? Katrina Lockley, Human Rights. Okay. Mariana Nascimento Meyer, Information Sciences. Oluwabukola Abdurindran, Information Sciences. Raquel Pena. Julian Mello. Ryan Merrow. Patrick Miller. Matt Moran. Sustainable Development. Alexandra McCoy, History. Anna Matveyeva, Economics. Dylan Lee, Political Science Statistics. Brian Lee, Computer Science. Zongming Liu, Economics Mathematics. Henry Molina, Computer Science. Maxwell Martin, Economics. Isabel McGill, Computer Science. Samata McAlvey, Computer Science. Omer Mustel, Computer Science. Tyga Maloney, Political Science. Alexander Mayer, Financial Economics. Sebastian Mayer, Economics. Anna Moore, Economics. Mohanad Mohammed, Computer Science. Devin Monahan, Economics. Jonathan Marconian, Anthropology. Erica Meltzer, Philosophy. Jordan McColney, Creative Writing. Jeff Montero, American Studies. Desiree Michelle Molina, Human Rights. Han Cheng Ma, Economics Philosophy. Max Mesro, History. Ryan Milkman, Political Science. John McKnight, Biological Sciences. Mario Torres, Creative Writing. Jordan Monaghan, Creative Writing, English. Elizabeth Malanga, Anthropology, Italian. Pierre Michel, Financial Economics. Neelam Monroy, political science. Macha Martin Camus, comparative literature and society. Molly Martin. Lorna McGonigal, psychology. Connor Metz, astrophysics, earth sciences. Maureen Knoll, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. Anna Maher, history. Chloe Moret, history. Dara McMahon, history. Lucy Miller, history. Garrett Modest, sustainable development. Astea Mahari-Rikutet, economics. Rivki Mandel, philosophy. Thank you. McGill. Gianna McGill, psychology. Joseph Musa, financial economics. Moira Ma, computer science. Aline Mabei, Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. Khan Nguyen, economics. Harvey Ng, computer science. Sophia Novak, psychology. Juna No, political science. Manami Nagi, urban studies. Nolwyn Menard, philosophy. Alexander Ng, computer science. Emily Nelson, computer science. Anne Nguyen, medical humanities. Sarah Nabire, sustainable development. Aaron O'Bannon, history. Pooja Patel, philosophy. Rubab Punawala, human rights. Juna Pitoski, American studies. Roberto Pacheco, philosophy. Blessing Uzauza, music. Azazua, Blessing Azazua, music. Chris O'Connor, neuroscience and behavior. Mark Orolos Ximenes, philosophy. Elise Otamani, economics. Nicole Polescu, neuroscience and behavior. Chatice Renee Pope, human rights. Roddy Piskovhov, economics. Ludasan Richmond, visual arts. Benjamin Pagovich, economics. Victoria Perez Giannone, architecture. Shayla Perry. Ian Park, computer science. Emily Peterson, film and media studies. Haley Olson, evolutionary biology of the human species. Julian Prujansky, economics. Huyen Park, mathematics. Lorraine Pena, economics philosophy. Antonia Perez, history. Latasha Palmer, African American studies. Charissa Ratliff Diodario, sociology. Alexander Richter, economics philosophy. Alicia Russo, economics. Tess Roche, economics. Marla Rink, political science. Natanya Rosen, philosophy, psychology.
Ustas?
Ustas Pakusias, Sustainable Development. Max Kintalian Barrison, Psychology. Hunter Rhodes, Human Rights. Angel Fatima Roni, Neuroscience and Behavior. Nuhai Rafthia, Computer Science. Sophia Rimey, Creative Writing. Alex Smith, Theater Arts. Michelle Saavedra Yeyena, Psychology. Christina Rizzo, English. Igor Ray, Political Science. Emanuela Rosenfeld, Psychology. Antonio Rodriguez, Ethnicity and Race Studies. Amber Ray, Economic Psychology. Katya Ryabinkina, Economics. Tyler Ryu, Data Science. Shahir Rahman, Economics, Political Science. Emily Glenn Robinson, Art History. Baylor Tischler, Neuroscience and Behavior. Connor Spangfort, English. Benjamin Shcherbakov, Political Science. Sean Shaskowski, Architecture. Joanna Schottlundner, Neuroscience and Behavior. Colton Sears, East Asian Studies. Natsumi Sasabi, Theater Arts. Aviram Rispler, Financial Economics. Evan Wark, History. Claire Rigney, Political Science. Meredith Silfen, Political Science. Marie Samba, Ethnicity and Race Studies. Zachary Trinidad, Political Science. Robert Van Battenberg, History. Beatrice Verillo, Financial Economics. Ronnie Vasquez, Economics. Noah Simon, Economics, Political Science. Griffin Utz, Political Science. Athena Sternklar, Political Science. Dylan Michael Schubert, Psychology. Aliyah Sua, Human Rights. Pengfei Ren, Economics, Mathematics. Qiyang Shen, Mathematics, Statistics. Crystal Sun, Mathematics, Statistics. Zhangha Yu, Sustainable Development. Maris Welch, Sustainable Development. Ian Wagner, Computer Science. Nicholas Whitman, Political Science. Stella Vasso, Political Science. Yuben Seo, Computer Science. Julie Sa, Psychology. Jinantali Ava Sadana, Anthropology. Che Stripple, Medical Humanities, Sustainable Development. Xiang Jun Shin, Computer Science. Hiwad Khan Shalamakel, Political Science. Jai Zhu, Economics. Joel Wen, Neuroscience and Behavior. Zifan Wang, Computer Science. Kiani Wu, Computer Science. K.E. Wong, Economics, Mathematics. Judy Wu, Mathematics, Statistics. Samuel Slater, Ethnicity and Race Studies. Isabella Satori, Financial Economics. Inan Shirazi, Computer Science. Bar Shladov, Computer Science and Mathematics, Financial Economics. Reagan Schwepp, History. Clement Streif, Philosophy. Sophia Youssef, Anthropology, Film and Media Studies. Clary Yi, English. Ziyang Yu, Financial Economics. Itay Zaram, Computer Science. Chi Chang Xing, Economics, Mathematics. Zachary Shi, Financial Economics. George Sanders, Mathematics. Ramsha Shahid, Economics. Samuel Shi, Political Science. Scott Slater, Political Science. Jennifer Sung, Political Science. Clive Thompson, Film and Media Studies. Laura Mejia Pinilla, Psychology. Shulin Zhang, Neuroscience and Behavior Sustainable Development. Patrick Zhang, Financial Economics. Sophia Trujillo, Psychology. Yael Simon, Neuroscience and Behavior. Brittany Cheney, History. Mimi Tompkins, English. Hussein Tamuri, English. Jonah Sheen Tan, Political Science. Ernest Tan, Computer Science. Malaika Tai, Human Rights. Isabella Safi LTT, Human Rights. Catherine Irene Tomlinson, Film and Media Studies. Luciana Talamas Steinbach, Comparative Literature and Society. Jason Trin, History. Anushka Tarahe, Computer Science. Titunen Tardevent, Neuroscience and Behavior. Raphael Taub, Economics, Mathematics. Leah Toulemond, Political Science. Thiel? Okay. Nicholas Thiel, Political Science. Cecilia Tatax, Information Science. Bia Yurovsky, Sustainable Development. Zazo van Luschert, Sustainable Development. Amanda Van Dyke, Political Science. Andy Tran, Political Science. Alessandra Varnes, Political Science. Sean Tai, Computer Science. Jay Vasquez, Philosophy. Paul Williams III, Film and Media Studies. Ryan Wee, Financial Economics. Omar Woods, Religion. Justin Wilson, Biological Sciences. Boaz Willis, Yiddish Studies. Matthias Weiser, Computer Science. Nicholas Wu, Computer Science. Maxwell Wilson, History. Yu Zhao, Computer Science and Mathematics. Arda Yurtuk, Human Rights. Olena Jastowska, Political Science. Jeremy Zhang, Sustainable Development. Simeon Yanev, Creative Writing. Justin Neo, Biological Sciences. Amir Yogev, Political Science. Wayad Zaid, History. Yang Gong Yun, Biological Sciences. Suying Zhang Cheng, Financial Economics. Ambrose Zhu, Economics. Jay Yang, Economics. Froilan Arias, Financial Economics. Zuzanna Bijoch, Financial Economics. Alexander Ximenes. Congratulations, class of 2023.
To your Dean of Students, who called all your names, Dean Marlyn Delva. That was a lot of work. And also want to recognize who handed your degrees, Vice Dean Curtis Rogers. Cherish this day and remember as we took these pictures, I was the class of 1990, and when I had the honor to become dean, I sent my father, Steve Rosen, who's watching us virtually, to find that picture with Ward Dennis, who is the dean. So one day, you might be the dean of SEPA, the dean of GS, and we know we just wish you success, love, health, and all good things. Dream big, and congratulations again, class of 2023. It is now my deep honor to welcome to the podium the GS class of 2023 valedictorian, Zuzanna Bijoch. Zuzanna was born in Poland and worked as a high fashion model before beginning her studies at Columbia. She participated in major fashion weeks around the globe, was featured on the covers of Vogue, Harper's Bazaar, and Elle, and was also a guest judge on Poland's Top Model. She received the Poland Women of the Year Award presented by Glamour Magazine in Poland. She also drew on her experiences growing up in the fashion industry to write and publish a novel, Modelka. At Columbia, Zuzanna worked as a research assistant in the Department of Economics and won the Romain Prize for her seminar paper titled, The Role of Activist Ownership and Management Sentiment in Corporate Spin-off Value Creation. She has held leadership roles in the Columbia Economic Society and the Lion Fund, a student-run hedge fund. Zuzanna was named to the Dean's List and is a member of the GS Honor Society and Phi Beta Kappa. She graduates summa cum laude with a degree in financial economics and will join BDT and MSD Partners in New York City. Please welcome to the stage and to the podium, with my deepest congratulations, this year's valedictorian of the Columbia School of General Studies, Zuzanna Bijoch.
Thank you, Dean Rosen-Metsch, for this introduction. Good morning, President Bollinger, esteemed Columbia administrators, faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, congratulations to the GS class of 2023. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Zuzanna, and I am originally from Poland. And before starting at Columbia, I had a career in modeling, which led me around the world and ultimately brought me to New York City. I also wrote a book in which I described my experiences of growing up in the world of fashion. So when I found out that I would be giving a speech as this year's class valedictorian, I took inspiration from one of New York's most notable writers and ultimate fashion icon, Carrie Bradshaw. So with this inspiration in mind, here it goes. Columbia University, the most desirable bachelor degree in the city. Striking good looks, impeccable taste, sterling reputation. A pedigree that would intimidate even the highest class of prospective students. And who was I? A simple girl from Poland trying to navigate the city that never sleeps. Was I crazy to believe that I belonged in the classrooms of an Ivy League institution? Just like many college relationships, my relationship with Columbia started with a direct message, or more precisely, me sending my application to the GS admission office. Luckily, GS and I were match made in heaven. GS values those of us with unique backgrounds and who have taken less traditional paths in their educations. And after years in fashion of being told, you're either in or you're out, I was looking for a more committed relationship. But of course, it wasn't all romantic walks down Riverside Park or holding hands at Low Beach. We certainly had a few rough patches. Yes, I'm looking at you, econometrics. But there are plenty of fun and memorable moments along the way. So now, looking back on these wonderful years, I couldn't help but wonder, what have I learned from this relationship? Number one, the best relationships encourage you to grow and change. After declaring to my parents that my major was going to be financial economics, imagine their surprise when I also told them that my first semester's course load consisted of astronomy, reggae, and German fairy tales. Columbia's commitment to its core studies, although sometimes unconventional, is an amazing opportunity to explore topics you may never have the chance to learn at any other point in your life. Number two, our differences make us stronger. We all have different life experiences, ambitions, and careers, and we should be proud of ourselves for following our own paths which have brought us here. In fact, this incredible variety of unique perspectives, ideas brought to campus from around the globe, made our time here even more special. Today, we wear the same caps and gowns, a symbol of one Columbia family. But we are also a clear proof that there is not just one single recipe for life. And finally, number three, cherish the time you have together. Living in New York City, we are constantly challenged to keep up with the fast pace of the city, focusing ourselves on our future goals and how will we get there. However, if we only look ahead, we lose sight of the present. As the famous Cornell alum, Andy Bernard, once said, "I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've actually left them." Well, as a student at Columbia, I've always known. So let's enjoy this. We made it. Step back and look at what we have all accomplished, and celebrate this day with your family and friends who supported you throughout this journey. And just like that, as many college romances go, the time has come for us to move on. I wouldn't say we've broken up. It's more of a conscious uncoupling. Dear Columbia, it's not you, it's me. I mean, I will never forget you. But in all seriousness, thank you to all of our professors, my fellow students, and last but not least, thank you to Columbia for taking a chance on all of us. Congratulations again to the GS class of 2023.
Thank you, Zuzanna, for those inspirational remarks. Let me now say a final congratulations for today to the treasured graduates of the class of 2023, your families, loved ones, and friends. I am honored to be your dean now and for years to come as you join our strong Columbia GS alumni community. You embody in a spectacular way the mission and vision of GS and Columbia. I hope you will stay involved with your Columbia family far into the future. Now I invite you all to continue the celebration of our amazing graduates at the Class Day reception to be held on Ansel Plaza. As you exit, there will be student marshals ready to guide you. Since we are all headed to the same place, I ask that our guests remain seated and allow the stage party to exit first. I also ask our graduates to remain and stand in place for a class photograph and make sure you have your head out so we could try to get everybody. And again, please remain in place, and then the graduates will exit, followed by their families and friends. Thank you for being part of our school. Thank you for who you are, and we love you. Candidates, please rise for the photograph.
Family and friends on the west side to the left of the stage, we ask that you do please exit the tent promptly and safely as possible. You can meet your graduates on the upper campus at Ansel Plaza. If you are on the east side to the right of the stage, we do ask that you wait until the grads have exited. Thank you.